So somehow it's that time of year again where I kind of look back at the last 12 months and see, well, what I've done on the van. I kind of forgot, to be honest. I had to look at all the pictures from the last 12 months. And yeah, back in January, this thing was still on its side. No wheels, no paint, not even any primer. Most of it was still sat in. The zinc primer I'd sprayed on to just protect all the welds. So yeah, we've got a lot done this year. I had to learn a lot. Never painted before, never done any bodywork prep. But I think I'm pretty happy with what we've achieved. So yeah, going back to January, I think, like I say, this was still sat in the old paint with all the panels welded in. I think around March time I started putting it back on the jig. Oh, sorry, yeah, took it off the jig, back onto its wheels, and then finally pushed it out of it for the first time in, yeah, March or April time. And then from there, pretty much the entire summer, I spent more or less 4 days a week, evenings plus weekends, prepping the body for paint. So yeah, putting the filler on, putting the primer on, rubbing it down, realising I'm screwed up, doing it a bit more, finally to the point where at the end of September, we were ready to paint it. I took 4 days off, and did it all in 4 days, which was stupid, to be honest, because I worked it out, it was 56 hours over 4 days. By the end of it, I was shattered. But hopefully, the results speak to themselves. I couldn't really have done this on my own. There's been a lot of people that, behind the scenes or just generally have helped me. So obviously Max, my wife, has helped a huge amount. I don't think I'd have eaten for the last 12 months if it wasn't for her. She's been very understanding of me wanting to get this done this year, and we're not too far off. There's been a few other people that have kind of helped me over the last 12 months. So around about March time, Wayne came in next door, and spent a couple of months restoring his van, and that was a good morale boost because I wasn't down here prepping on my own for months at a time. A few other people I'd like to thank is Richie Rivers over at Southern Dustless Blasting. He's done a lot of shut blasting bits for me and fitting me in when he can. There's Simon Ballard down the road at NOSVW. He's helped me out on quite a few occasions. When I couldn't fit ball joints, took it down, he fitted them for free. Bought bits and pieces off him and he's just given me general advice, which has been great. But yeah, we'll have a quick nosy. See what you think. So most of this you probably would have already seen. So I've started cutting and polishing it. I've done this corner. I haven't done any of this side. If you move up to the front, dash is pretty much built up now. It's got the wheel to go back in and a few other bits. And then I've got the gearbox and the engine over there. So my current plan, I'll just put this back. Current plan is the MOT on my little car runs out at the end of March. And I don't want to renew it, so I want this thing done. But I'll drive over by the end of March. So realistically, I'm going to say end of Feb, and that gives me a bit of leeway. So I've got the first week of Jan off. I'm hoping in that week I can get the engine and gearbox in. Hopefully the pop top on, get that out of the way. And then, what else have we got left? I need to carpet line, put the floor in, back of the van so I can get the windows in, because I don't want to put the windows in and then carpet line around them because it looks horrible. So I think it's achievable. But it's just a matter of time, isn't it? So we'll see what happens. Fingers crossed, this thing will be, like I say, on the road end of March. And I won't be spending another winter down here, which will be a delight. So yeah, I'll see you in the new year. Cheers for following and everything.